We find in Africa after independence a situation where we simply inherited the legal systems. Let me use South Africa as an example. In the Constitution of South Africa, it is recognized that we have an extensive chapter on human rights, the Bill of Rights. But when we go to the content part of the law, then we say we do have the common law, customary law, and of course, other like international law. When you then go to ask, what is this common law? The common law is Roman Dutch law. The law imported by the Romans to South Africa, which also applies in Namibia, in Lesotho, in Swaziland, to an extent in Zimbabwe, and so on. And you say, what is common about it? These were indigenous laws of those colonizers, which they came with and transplanted. And now you say you are independent and liberating yourself, and you make those part of your law. And you separate them from African law, which you call customary law, but which were distorted during the colonial period, so you are not even engaged in damage control or in trying to look at what were the basis of those justice. And so we don't. And yet we say we are professors of law and so on. We are actually pathetic to the societies in which we live and so on. So that is an example that one can give, and it applies to virtually all former colonial African countries with no exception. We have legal practitioners. In fact, in many of our courts, you still find even legal practitioners going to court with robes, with gowns, with a knee. And they say that is a place of justice. And you think that our citizens who used to go there to watch the colonialists wear like that, they don't believe there is justice. But we are not sensitive to that because we think this is what it is. We are doing it like they do it in London or in New York, and therefore we are civilized, you know. They recognize us, and we are invited to go and give lectures and say, I'm visiting professor here, I was doing this and this at Harvard, at where, and so on and so on. What I'm saying is we are part of the problem. Then we do have in Africa, I'm jumping from what did we inherit and how did we fail to change things, to say there are new areas of law which are evolving globally today where we are still colonized. We do have an example. For example, I will give two examples. One is the challenge of piracy within the Indian Ocean near Eastern Africa at the moment. The people involved say they are defending their territory against foreign fishing and so on. But they are, in a way, both pirates and liberators of their resources. But what is important there is that there is no law now, legal regime, on where the Somali people who are arrested can be tried at all, can be prosecuted. So what has happened is Kenya and Sicily have signed a pact with the US and the AU to prosecute the people who are arrested by the Americans and the NATOs in those waters on their behalf so that Kenya and the Seychelles can get some aid from the US and so on. What a ridiculous thing. How can you allow yourself to be a center of prosecution of people within a legal system which does not exist because they did not commit crime in your territory, and so on. But you bring, in other words, you engage in illegalities and so on. And we talk about the rule of law internationally and so on. The very same people tell you how they want to create international legal regime where we, and so forth. Another one is the International Criminal Court. Since the Rome Statute, to which we participated very strongly in building, was put in place, what has happened is that any little conflict in Africa, the matter is referred to Rome, and then prosecution is being suggested. But the Rome Court, the International Criminal Court, was created before the US invaded Iraq and destroyed Iraq. There's no single reference to crimes committed in Iraq going to the International Criminal Court. It was long before the atrocities that Israel has committed in the Gaza and the Palestine and so on. There's no reference to any before. So an International Criminal Court, which you are told is building a regime of justice in the world, is selectively being used to depict the African as the region of criminals. The people who commit crime are not those who do it 100 times more. And that is the regime we do. Are we teaching these things in our own law schools? Are our curriculum being transformed? No, it is not being done. So what should we do? Let me go quickly to some of the things I do. I suggest from point 7 onwards, let us decolonize our minds. Before we decolonize our minds, it is going to be very difficult to decolonize the law, legal systems, and the justice system so that our people can begin to feel that they are living in a system of constitutionalism and the rule of law. We have laws, but no rule of law. We have constitutions, but no constitutionalism. These are some of our problems. So we must start with ourselves. Let us decolonize our minds. Secondly, let us look at the legal curriculum and say, do we want to go with the boundaries that have been created in disciplines to such an extent that a person doing law has no idea of simple areas in issues of agriculture, issues of science, even elementary maths, and so on? They are lawyers, and so forth. When you go to court and you are dealing with legal disputes, some involve science, technology issues, some involve environmental issues, some involve financial issues, but the lawyer we produce is a half educated, but with distinctions, cum laude, this and that, this and that. We must transform so that we increase the level of interdisciplinarity in the way in which we construct education in our universities. Third, we need to be able to enhance values. What are the core values and identities of the people around issues of justice? And indeed, I have a book here which I recently edited called Shared Values, Constitutionalism and Democracy in Africa. Those at the University of Science, Malaysia, don't worry, I gave the principal, the vice chancellor, a copy, so it will be in your library, don't worry. But it tries to look at why, because we have not distilled shared values in Africa's historiography before colonialism, during and after, we are not able to build a coherent African vision of justice and so on. Thirdly, we need also to really begin to look at what are the new areas of development of law. In African universities, the African Union is busy. For example, we have the African Charter on Human and People's Rights of 1981. It introduced for the first time in the history of the world the right to development as a right. Do we teach it in our universities? No, we don't. Have we developed scholarship around it, what it means? No, we don't. But we cite the European Court of Human Rights. We cite the Inter-American this and that. We cite, you know. So even where we have our own regional body with trying to infuse some of the paradigms that we have, we are lazy and we do not do scholarship enough, research, publish in those areas so that we have something. But we continue saying our universe, our curriculum has not changed. Who is going to change it if we don't? And so on. We have from Durban 2001 recommendations in the action plan calling for reparation for slavery, for colonialism, and so on. Has any African scholar, legal scholar, or in curriculums put those? And this applies also to Asia and so on, because that was a world conference. We have not incorporated those. So in other words, we are lazy bums. And so on, and we are part of the problem, and so on. Under the international regime, when there are problems like in Libya, like Egypt, Tunisia, and so on, and when the leaders are being removed by their own people's uprising, then all of a sudden you hear, oh, we are freezing the assets of Gaddafi in the US, in Britain, in Swaziland, which means they were keeping stolen wealth. We need a legal system in our universities and practice which is going to say, declare all stolen wealth that you have in your banks in the north, so that the people can, don't wait for a crisis, so that when the people whose money you are keeping and building your economies are now in trouble, you say you are all of a sudden discovered them. You are lying. Anybody who keeps stolen property in our, most of our legal systems are part of criminals. So we are dealing with criminals in the north, and our law schools are not teaching us sufficiently to be able to really pursue justice and so on. There's a lot that we can say. I can see the chair is looking at me and so on, but I must say that there is a lot we have in common, and decolonization of our law and legal systems in Africa and Asia is something we have no choice but to do. If we don't, then we are conceding we want to remain colonized and slaves. Thank you.